Hey guys, Brian here with WP Cupid Blog, and today I'm going to be showing you how to install WordPress on Hostgator step by step. In this video, I'm going to be going over four different steps to get WordPress installed with Hostgator. Step one is how to sign up for an account with Hostgator. Step two is choosing a hosting package. Step three is registering a domain name. And then step four is installing WordPress on Hostgator. I provide a link in the description below to Hostgator's site. If you use the link I provided, you will get a discount on your web hosting. You will get 43% off your Hostgator hosting. Hostgator also provided me with a promo code to get your web hosting for only a penny for the first month. The promo code is Cupid17. I have provided the promo code in the description below. Feel free to follow along with me in the video. Some awesome features you will get with Hostgator's hosting is a one-click WordPress install, 24/7 support from Hostgator. They also have award-winning support. They offer a 45-day money-back guarantee. You'll also receive over $200 in advertising offers from Google and Bing. Hostgator is one of the top web hosting providers, and Hostgator powers over 8 million domains worldwide. Feel free to walk through the steps with me to start installing WordPress on Hostgator. Before we get started, a little disclosure. The link is an affiliate link. I'll receive a commission which helps support this channel and helps us put out WordPress tutorial videos on a regular basis. Let's get started. To start off, you want to visit Hostgator via the link I provided below. Once you click the link, you will see Hostgator's web hosting page like you see here. You'll see three different plans you can choose from: the hatchling plan, the baby plan, and the business plan. The plan I recommend going with is the hatchling plan. You can have one domain name with this plan. You can always scale up to one of the other two plans if you need to. If you have more than one website, you will want to go with the baby plan, as this includes unlimited domains. Go ahead and select the hosting plan you want by clicking the Sign Up Now button. You will now be on a page where you can choose your domain name. Type in the domain name you would like to use along with the domain extension, for example, .com, .net, .org, etc. I recommend going with a .com if you can, as this is the most common domain extension. If you already have a domain name, just click on the I already own this domain and put in your domain name. Once you do that, you want to choose the hosting plan. Just make sure the hosting type is the correct plan, or the hosting package type is the correct plan you want. Next, you want to choose the billing cycle. You can choose to pay monthly, every 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, 24 months, and 36 months. You will see you will save the most money the farthest out you purchase your hosting for. If you want to take advantage of our promo code provided by Hostgator, you will get hosting for just a penny for the first month. If you plan on purchasing your hosting for 3 months or 6 months, it is cheaper for you to use the promo code for the penny offer. To get the penny offer, you have to choose 1 month, and then you'll just pay a penny. So keep that in mind. If you plan on purchasing your hosting for 12 months or longer, you don't want to use the penny hosting promo code that I've provided, as it's going to be more expensive for you. By you clicking the link that I provided in the description, you're going to get 43% off, and that's going to be cheaper than the penny hosting promo code. So do keep that in mind. Next, you want to enter your username. Pick anything you would like. Next, just enter your 4-digit PIN. Make sure to remember this, as this is used when you need to talk to Hostgator support. Next, you want to enter your billing information. Over on the right-hand side, you will see where you can put in your card information, or you can pay via a PayPal account. After you input this information, go to the next section where you can add additional services if you would like to. You will see protect your site from hackers. I will say there are plenty of free security alternatives for WordPress, so it isn't necessary. You will see get a professional email address from Google. I'd unselect this as you get free email accounts with the Hostgator hosting. Select this only if you prefer to do it via Google. Next, you will see backup your hard work. This will create a backup of your site. I'd unselect this as there are free alternatives that work just as well. Next, you will see HTTPS SSL certificates. In order to get this, you have to have the baby hosting plan or above. A SSL certificate protects sensitive customer information. The next section is where you can add a coupon code. If you want to receive Hostgator hosting for a penny for a month, just type in Cupid17 and click validate. I've also provided this promo code in the description below. Now scroll down, and if you selected hosting for just a month, you will get the penny hosting. If you plan to buy hosting for 3 months or 6 months, you will get a discount by using this offer. For hosting 12 months or more, don't use this promo code as the original offer page. You get a bigger Hostgator discount. Now, just scroll down and accept the terms and conditions and click the Checkout Now button. You will now be directed to a thank you page. Hostgator will now email your Hostgator receipt and your Hostgator cPanel login credentials. Once you get the email, just click the link and log into the Hostgator cPanel. Once you are logged in, we want to install WordPress. You should see at the top under popular links a install WordPress option. Just click this to install WordPress on Hostgator. Next, you want to choose your domain name. You can pick it from the drop-down. Leave the box next to it where it says directory blank. Now just click next. Now it will say blog title. You want to put in the name of your site here. Enter the admin username, password, and other information to use for when logging into WordPress. Next, check the automatically create a new database and check that you agree to the terms and conditions. Once you do that, click the Install Now button. You will now be redirected to a installation complete page that lists out your WordPress login credentials. Now you want to enter your domain name at the top of the search engine and put a /wp-admin, just like you see here. This will take you to the WordPress login page for your site. You'll receive an email with a link from Hostgator with a login URL as well. Once you log in you will be in the WordPress dashboard where you can begin creating your site. Towards the top, you will see your site title, and if you hover over it, you will see View Site. Click either one and you'll see the WordPress default theme currently being used. Now you just need to customize the site and make it look however you would like. A great place to get premium WordPress themes is Mojo Marketplace. I included the link in the description below. You can get already professional made WordPress themes if you don't want to bother designing your site, etc. You have successfully installed WordPress on Hostgator. Alright guys, thanks for watching. That is how to install WordPress on Hostgator. I provided a step-by-step summary of this video via text in the description below. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more WordPress video tutorials.